So today I've got kind of a different video for you. It's not going to be a fishing video. It's actually technically an unboxing. I did open it already. Whoops. But I was too excited. I just really excited about getting this. But before I get to what's in this box, I'm just going to say, sorry, I can't make a fishing video this week. My wife and I are in the middle of a big move. We're moving from Farmington to Durango. And it's an hour or so drive. We've made the trip back and forth with our car probably 8 times already. So we're tired. We're working our butts off with our other jobs also. So it's just, I don't have time this week. Every single moment I have, I'm having to head down to the other house, pick up more items, more boxes. We're literally living out of boxes right now. And anyone that's ever moved knows what I'm talking about. So just gonna have to skip the fishing video. I'll still have the fly tying though, so don't worry about that. You'll be able to check out any of my fly tying videos. I will have one this coming Friday. But for today, this is the video. It's not gonna be a fishing video, but it is an unboxing. So let's get to that. So I did open it, and I checked what's in here just to make sure, but I haven't done anything with it. It's literally in the same thing as how it came. So basically, what I've got is the Maverick reel, but I got two of them. I don't know if you remember in one of my videos, I fished with these reels with one of these, the 5-weight. Joe came up and brought one of these, all right, for me to fish with. So here's what they come in. This is the box. And I like these so much. I mean, really, for the price, I just don't think there's much out there that is better. I don't think there's anything better. I don't think there's anything even remotely close. But I got two. I like them so much, I got two of them. So I'm replacing my 5-weight. This is a 5-weight. You can see right there, 5-6. Okay, this is my 5-weight reel. I'm replacing my Sage 2200. Said that one was a 3-4 weight, and the other was a 5-6 weight, and the other was 7-9 weight, 7 through 9 weight, which is what the box says. I went to spool my line on, I had a 4-weight line that I went to spool on my, what this says, 3-4. I didn't order online, so I didn't order with Joe online. I just basically told him I needed, I was getting a 3-weight rod, and I needed, you know, the reel that would match that. That's what he sent. So unfortunately, when he got these boxes, they were printed wrong, and he could not get a refund from the company that printed them. So he has to use those boxes. Unfortunately, the boxes are wrong. They're actually a 2-3 weight, and then a 4-5 weight, and then a 6-7-8 weight, I believe, for that last one. So this is a 2-3. So my line doesn't fit on there, but that's okay. I'll put it on my 5-6. And anyway, so that's, I just want to let you know that if you do order these reels just from this video, not a 3-4, okay? It's a 2-3. So it's 2-3, 4-5, and 6-7-8, I believe, okay? So the smallest one is a 2-3, 2-weight and 3-weight. The middle one is the 4-weight, 5-weight, okay? So keep that in mind. Don't, you know, when you order online, it'll tell you that. So, yeah. And if any of you have ever fished 2200, you know, they're good reels. They're good reels, but they are cast aluminum. They're not fully machined, which these are, and they're in the same price point. These are fully machined, and they're about the same price as the Sage 2200. Let me grab my other reel really quick, and I want to show you what I'm talking about here. All right, so I grabbed my Sage 2200, and this is the reel. And I have fished this a lot, don't get me wrong. This has been put through the grinder, beat up bad. Fished it on rocks where I set it down, and it's gotten plenty of dunks. I mean, it's a good reel, don't get me wrong. But this is cast aluminum, and then also, it's just painted. They just literally paint over it to make it black. Okay, but you're gonna see all those little chips and everything where they show through really, really strongly. It doesn't really stay nice looking. Again, I've beat the crap out of this thing. This thing has really had a lot of hard use, and it's still doing good. I mean, up until I found the Maverick reel, until I met Joe and saw his reels at the price point that they are. I mean, this is the best reel I could find for a little over $100, $120, $130. It's the best reel I could find at that. It is cast, it is, you know, I mean, they've got decent drags and everything. But then I found Joe, and I got the Maverick reel. So let's go ahead and open up the 5.6. It's the same one as my Sage 2250. They also come with these really cool neoprene reel socks, I guess you would call it. This is so nice. Just has such a different feel. It's also much lighter. This is a lot heavier. Of course, this has line on it. I do know that, but still, it is much, much lighter. I think this is, off the top of my head, I want to say like 5.5 to 6 ounces. And I believe this is 4.2 ounce, I want to say. Don't quote me on that. If I'm wrong, I'll put everything up on the video and in the description section. So, but everything on this reel is made really nicely. You know, the only thing is that the knob here is plastic, but it looks like pretty heavy-duty plastic. It's not anything that, you know, is gonna break. And really, in reality, I think the plastic kind of has almost a nicer feel. I mean, it's not gonna be super cold in the cold mornings with up against the, you know, it's gonna insulate a little better. So maybe that's a good thing. But just right off the bat, that's the only thing I see that makes me go, you know. But other than that, everything else is perfect. So here's that reel. You can see, it's a really nice looking reel. Got that cool kind of X design, open frame. And it's, I don't know if you can hear that, but it's got a really nice soft sound kind of clicker on it. It's not super loud. I mean, some of these that you hear, you know, someone's just stripping out some of their line, it's like, oh, does someone have a fish? You know, everyone looks, and I think that kind of gets annoying. So these are nice and soft sounding, which I do like. The open frame design is really nice. So basically, to take off the spool, you just unscrew that. And that's pretty nice. So I thought that would actually pop off, but that keeps, so this part keeps from coming off, so that way you don't lose it on the river. That's actually really neat. Good thought, Joe. So there we go, that's what we got. So there's the frame, and then there's the spool. And then they've got, the spool has, you can see there's like little grooves right there. And then the spool has that on the inside also. And that just, when you stick it on there, you gotta make sure that they line up, which that is. And then just screw that back in. All right, and that stops, so you don't over-tighten it. And then the drag, you know what, I'm gonna scoot you guys a little closer here. All right, this is better. I don't have to reach all the way over, but. So the drag knob is on the inside here, so you don't accidentally move it while you're fishing, okay? And that has a nice soft little click just to like let you know you did one turn, two turn, three turn, okay? So that's kind of nice. And I do like that about it. And the drag is really smooth. I was mentioning that on that last video that I made. So that video, I think, I want to say it was my sixth video, maybe seventh, where I went out and fished with Joe and he brought one of these reels. But this is such a smooth drag. There's just no like you know, of course it's new, but it is smoother, I think, than this. I mean, it could over time, I don't know. I haven't fished it over time, but that's pretty smooth drag. And I've got it on three. Now, if you really wanna, you know, go real soft, you know, there's one. And I feel a little bit more than it was at zero. You know, you go to two and even a little more. But it's all smooth. Let's go ahead and just ramp it up and let's go to eight. Wow, okay. Can't really even turn it. That's too much. But that's still smooth. And the only reason it seems jerky is because it's kind of hard to grab it right now because I'm not... because it's open frame. There we go. Really smooth. I mean, I'm for trout fishing on five weight, you're just never gonna need that much. But yeah, that's really, really smooth. So there is the five weight. It's got a really nice kind of like a forest green, dark kind of frame. Beautiful, really nice looking reel. Super light, just really well made, you know, and it's not overly, I mean, it is really well machined, but some of these I find, they're overly machined. I find that they, sorry, I have to duck to get in the camera. I'm kind of not set up for this right now. Like I said, we just moved in, so we're, you know, it is what it is, guys, sorry. This is going to be just kind of impromptu type of, you know, just video here. It's really well machined. It's really good job. I mean, there's really no hard corners here. So even like on the spool here, this is rounded and soft. There's no kind of sharpness to it. Any part here, it's nice and round. There's no sharpness. There's just nowhere that would catch on anything or whatnot. So it's nice and really well machined. That's all I can say about it. One thing I will say though is not so much done to lighten the reel that it makes it not rigid. This is pretty solid reel. I mean, he's even got a line in here to kind of keep everything together, but allows for really thin machining on here. But if that was all the way across and you didn't have this line down the center, then you would have a fragile reel. I mean, the reel would probably bend if you dropped it. I was talking to him while we were fishing. He said that he's, you know, just happens. He's dropped this reel so many times and never ever had much of an issue. And the nice thing is, it is anodized. Let's see if I can get this to focus. It is anodized aluminum, so you're not going to get all these really profound marks on it from dropping it or, you know, abrasion. I mean, sure, you're gonna get some, but because it's anodized aluminum, it's not like a paint, so it's not just gonna wear off like on that reel. It is fully, you know, machined and anodized, so this should be looking rather new for much longer, I think. I mean, yeah, that's the theory behind it, right? That's why companies do that. So anyway, there's the five weight. All the five weights are this green color. I'm gonna see if I can kind of talk them into making multiple different colors. I don't know what that would be. That might cost more, kind of be too difficult for them, but that would be kind of cool, I think. All right, Joe, so if you hear this, if you watch this video, something I would like is to see maybe multiple colors for each of the reels, each of the sizes. So that's a 5.6, which is only in green, but this is a pretty cool case. Just, it's a nice neoprene case that comes with it. All right, so now here is the three weight. I think this is 3.4. Yep, 3.4. I'm so excited about this. So I ordered new fly line for the 3.4 because I also, a little sneak peek kind of, not peek, just kind of like a little heads up, I have a rod being built for me for that, I think it's called Midwest Custom Fly Rods. And I like the one that my subscriber had sent me so much, I had to return it. and I missed it. So I had one custom built for me from the same guy. This is a 3-weight versus a 4-weight, and it's a 10-foot, so it's a Euro nymphing style rod, and but it's a 3-weight. So I'll show you that. We'll do kind of, I wouldn't call it an unboxing because it doesn't come in a box, but we'll do a video about that when I get it. That should come in another week or two. He said he's almost done with it. So, all right. So here is the 3-4 weight. My kid's crying. 1 second. So here is the 3-4 weight. Even lighter, smaller. Let's go ahead and take a look at that versus my, let's see the size difference for my Sage. And look at the 3-5. Now he makes a 6-7-8, I want to say, weight, which is even bigger. But here we go. You can see the size difference, just slightly different. But this is the 3-4 weight. It's really nice and compact. And I'm really excited. So that new fly rod that is coming, that custom built for me from Midwest, I think it's called, Midwest Custom Fly Rods, is coming, and that's what this is going to be paired up with. I'm going to put this on there because that's a 3-weight, and so is this. And I've got some custom line, not custom, I'm sorry, I've got some line coming. It's a double taper, and I'm getting that because primarily this is going to be a nymphing rod. That's all I'm going to use it for. It's a Euro nymphing style rod, and pretty much that's what I'm going to use it for. Occasionally I might throw on a dry fly, you know, but that's okay. I mean, double taper is not going to get out real far, but I mean, who cares, right? I don't, where I fish, I'm not getting out far anyway. I 30 yards at most, and that's about what a double taper does. So that's what I'm going to put on this. It's going to be a 3-weight double taper. And, so I'm really excited about that. I think this is going to look really nice. It's a dark chocolate brown, which is actually what I'm getting that rod wrapped in. It's a, so it's like a forest green, almost like this color blank. Okay. With a nice dark chocolate brown, wraps. And then I'm going to have it accented with, like a turquoise. It'll look interesting, but I like it. I it's going to kind of, my logo, it's going to kind of mimic the logo and colors. So anyway, this is the reel. This is a 3-weight, basically the same, just smaller and chocolate brown. Same thing, you just pull that off. There we go. And then that comes out and you just twist it and it pops in just like that. Then you can go ahead and twist it back on. You know, I kind of like that. You know, my Sage, you've got to kind of, you put your fingers like that and hold and then push and it pops out. But it doesn't, it's kind of not easy to do. There we go. And then, you know, and once you've got the line all kind of like this, and just, you know, trying to put it back, not easy with this reel. And I'm going to tell you right now, I think it's going to be a lot easier to put that back with, I messed up. I had this wrap around there, so I got to fix that. So it's annoying when I'm out on the river and I get like grime and stuff in there. It's hard to do that. But this, you know, you just twist this out, and being an open frame reel, I mean, really, sometimes you don't even need to pop this out because it is open frame. So if you get anything right in that track there, right? You see the track, which again, look at how well this is made. That track is not sharp edges. They actually machine that to make that nice and smooth. So it's not gonna cut you or anything like that. It's not sharp. It's nice and well machined. So anyway, so it's right in that track. And if something does get in there, right? Then you just, you can usually just stick it underwater and do that, and you've got the track free, usually. And if you really need to, then just pop this off. There you go. Rinse it. Back on, and you're good to go. I like it. I think it's a good design. I'm really excited about these reels. I think every single one of my reels is going to be replaced with this Maverick reel. I mean, I just could not turn down the price point. And in fact, I could go and sell this online for, you know, even though it's beat up and used, I think people would buy it probably for $80. Which actually, by the way, I'll probably sell this online. So if you guys are looking for a Sage 2200, pick it up. I'll probably put it on my eBay to sell it. Just keep on checking in the next couple weeks, and we'll see if I do that. But yeah, I mean, I think this one's like 120 for the 3-weight. This one was like 130. But for that price point, which is the same as a Sage, I would far rather have this reel. And I think I can go sell this for a decent amount of money, at least get some of it back. You know, but I think all my reels from now on are going to be this reel. Decent drag, quality reel, everything is good. There's no sharp edges, really well machined, and it is machined. For a machined reel, let's say with Sage, you got to go $220, so $100 more than this. Almost double. I mean, we're talking almost double, right? Because this is about 100 and change. And their 3300, which is their cheapest fully machined, is like 220, 230. And then you get, you know, any of the other companies, they're all the same, you know? Every single one of them. They're all, if for a fully machined reel, you're going to pay. You're going to pay over $200. I guarantee you will. I've had trouble finding fully machined reels under $200. And this is even better. This is almost 100. I mean, we're talking just 100 and change. I mean, it's not much more. So, anyway. Really excited about these reels. So, again, sorry guys. No fishing video this week. But hopefully next week we can... we can get a fishing video up. I'm hoping. I might need 2 weeks. We'll see. I can't hold her.
Yes, my love.
All right. Hopefully next week I can put out a video, a fishing video. You know, I might need 2 weeks though. It's a tough move when you got a kid. And by the way, some amazing news. We've got another kid on the way. My wife is preggo, so we are expecting another child. So when you've got a pregnant wife, a 3-year-old, and a dog, moves aren't easy. They're not easy as a single guy when I did it. They're a little more difficult as a married person and now a father. It's not an easy move and it might take 2 weeks. I'm having trouble trying to get, some of the furniture up this way. U-Haul is a little too expensive for us. We can't pay it because of the distance. You got to pay in your mileage. You got to pay something like 50 cents a mile or some crap like that. And so it would cost like $250 to rent a U-Haul, and we don't have that money. We're not rich. We just don't have it. So we're trying to move everything. Luckily I do know some people around here with trucks, and they've been gracious enough to give us a few trips back and forth. We were able to bring up our couch and our bed and our kids' bed, and those are the most important things. At least we can sleep up here and have somewhere to sit. But when it comes to dressers and stuff like that, we're right now living out of a suitcase because we don't have a dresser. But all of our other furniture is still back there, so we need to do a few more trips. And thankfully I've got some of that set up next week, but, hopefully I can do a video next week and get it up for you guys. But if not, then might be 2 weeks before I do a fishing video. But like I said before, we'll keep my, fly tying videos going. At least you'll be able to check those out. So please, you know, come back and watch in the next couple weeks. So anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Sorry this is kind of a boring video. It's not fishing. But hey, if you're like me and you're a gear guy, I mean, this, heck, I'm excited about watching videos on fishing gear, on new fishing gear. So I guess this might be a positive video. Maybe you guys like this. Let me know. Let me know if you like this kind of thing, or if you'd rather just watch a fishing video and never want to see unboxing ever again. But if you do like these, then let me know, and I'll try to do these regularly when I get gear, which hopefully is more often than not. I'm a regular guy like you guys. You know, I buy all this stuff out of my own pocket. I'm not supposed to talk about monetization with YouTube, but I'm just going to tell you right now, it doesn't pay enough to even pay for my gear. So this comes out of my pocket. This is not bought with money from YouTube. That wouldn't pay this. It would take months. Let's just go into that. It's not a lot of money, okay? So I do this for fun, okay, guys? I do. When I've got something in my life, like a move, I cannot just... It's not a job. I'm not getting paid for this. This is, it's a very small amount. It's not enough to not move. It's not enough to pay for a moving crew to be able to come and move all my stuff so I can make videos. I got to do it myself. I can't just... pick up and do it. So keep that in mind. When I do have a video, when I don't make a video, I'm gonna try. I keep on trying every single week. I'm gonna try to make one. But if I don't, sorry guys. I'll do what I can. Like I said, it's life. Sometimes, you know how life goes. It's not always. You don't always get to do what you plan. So anyway. Sorry for my rambling on, but I hope you enjoyed this video, and hopefully I'll see you guys next week on a fishing video. If not, I think my rod will come by then, and if I can't do a fishing video, then I will at least do an unboxing on that rod and maybe put this reel on with the line, and you guys can see what my next rod will be. That probably would be what I fish with from that point on. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Please subscribe. Down below, hit that subscribe button if you like this kind of video. If not, check out my other videos. I've got fly tying videos. I've got fishing videos. Check them out and please subscribe.